Peace and all. Good beloved, welcome to this time of evening prayer, assuming I get my stuff together here. Here comes Brother Seeger. Hey, buddy. His medicine time is coming up and his dinner time is coming up, so he's my best friend right now when there's food involved. So let's see here. Thursday evening. The Lord our God, the Almighty, reigns. Let us rejoice and exult and give God the glory. You are in the midst of us, O Lord, and we are called by your name. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And Brother Bodhidharma has joined us as well. Why don't you lay down, buddy? Give us today our daily bread. Now, my friends, all that is true, all that is noble, all that is just and pure, all that is lovable and gracious, whatever is excellent and admirable, with these let us fill our hearts, and the God of heaven will be with us. Jesus, you are the vine, your Father is the gardener, who breaks off every branch that bears no fruit, and prunes each one that does. We cannot bear fruit unless we remain in you. You are the vine. We are the branches. If we remain in you and your words remain in us, whatever we ask, we shall have. Your commandment is this: love one another just as I have loved you. You can have no greater love for your friends than to give your life for them. Jesus is the vine. Jesus makes us one. Jesus is our life. Hi, Sister Shiloh. We must be like newborn babes, always thirsty for spiritual milk, so that we may grow up to be saved. Our hearts and minds must be made completely new. We must get rid of that old self, which made us live as we did. We must put on the new self, created in God's likeness, revealed in the true life, which is upright and holy. Turning to Psalm 104. Let all that I am praise the Lord. O Lord, my God, how great you are. You are robed with honor and majesty. You are dressed in a robe of light. You stretch out the starry curtain of the heavens. You lay out the rafters of your home in the rain clouds. You make the clouds your chariot. You ride upon the wings of the wind. The winds are your messengers. Flames of fire are your servants. You place the world on its foundation so it would never be moved. You clothe the earth with floods of water, water that covered even the mountains. At your command, the waters fled. At the sound of your thunder, it hurried away. Mountains rose and valleys sank to the level you decree. Then you set a firm boundary for the seas, then you set a firm boundary for the seas so they would never again cover the earth. You make springs pour water into the ravines. So streams gush down from mountains. They provide water for all the animals, and the wild donkeys quench their thirst. The birds nest beside the streams and sing among the branches of the trees. You send rain on the mountains from your heavenly home, and you fill the earth with fruits of your labor. You cause grass to grow from the livestock and plants for people to use. You allow them to produce food from the earth, wine to make them glad, olive oil to soothe their skin, and bread to give them strength. The trees of the Lord are well cared for, the cedars of Lebanon that he planted. There are birds that make their nest and storks that make their homes in the cypresses. High in the mountains live the wild goats, and the rocks form a refuge for hyraxes. You made the moon to mark the seasons, and the sun to know when, and the sun knows when to set. You tend the darkness, and it becomes night, and all the forest animals prowl about. Then the young lions roar for their prey, stalking the food provided by God. At dawn, they slink back into their dens to rest. Then people go off to their work, where they labor until evening. O Lord, what a variety of things you have made. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Here is the ocean, vast and wide, teeming with life on every of your. Here is the ocean, vast and wide, teeming with life of every kind, both large and small. See the ships sailing along, and Leviathan, which you made to play in the sea. They all depend on you to give them food as they need. When you supply it, they gather it. You open your hands to feed them, and they are richly satisfied. But if you turn away from them, they panic. When you take away their breath, they die and turn again to dust. When you give them your breath, life is created, and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord continue forever. The Lord takes pleasures in all he has made. The earth trembles at its glance. The mountains smoke at his touch. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God to my last breath. May all my thoughts be pleasing to him, for I rejoice in the Lord. Let all sinners vanish from the face of the earth. Let the wicked disappear forever. Let all that I am praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And now turning to Deuteronomy chapter 19. The whole chapter. Nice long readings tonight, huh? So, chapter 19 of Deuteronomy. When the Lord your God destroys the nations whose land he is giving you, you will take over their lands and settle in their towns and homes. Then you must set apart three cities of refuge in the land the Lord is giving you. Survey the territory and divide the land the Lord your God is giving you into three districts, with one of these cities in each district. Then anyone who has killed someone can flee to one of the cities of refuge for safety. If someone kills another person unintentionally, without previous hostility, the slayer may flee to any of these cities and live in safety. For example, suppose someone goes into the forest with his neighbor to cut wood, and suppose one of them swings an axe to chop down a tree and the axe head flies off the handle, killing the other person. In such cases, the slayer may flee to one of the cities of refuge to live in safety. If the distance to the nearest city of refuge is too far, an enraged avenger might be able to chase down and kill the person who caused the death, then the slayer would die unfairly, since he had never shown hostility to the person who died. That is why I am commanding you to set aside three cities of refuge. And if the Lord your God enlarges your territory, as he swore to your ancestors, and gives you all the land he promised them, you must designate three additional cities of refuge. He will give you this land if you are careful to obey all the commands I have given you, if you always love the Lord your God and walk in his ways. That way you will prevent the death of innocent people in the land the Lord your God is giving you as your special possession. You will not be held responsible for the death of innocent people. But suppose someone is hostile toward a neighbor and deliberately ambushes and murders him, and then flees to one of the cities of refuge. In that case, the elders of the murderer's hometown must send agents to the city of refuge to bring him back and hand him over to the dead person's avenger to be put to death. Do not feel sorry for that murderer. Purge from the land the guilt of murdering innocent people. Then all will go well with you. When you arrive in the land that the Lord your God is giving you as a special possession, you must never steal anyone's land by moving the boundary markers your ancestors set up to mark their property. You must not convict anyone of a crime on testimony of only one witness. The facts of the case must be established by the testimony of two or three witnesses. If a malicious witness comes forward and accuses someone of a crime, then both the accuser and the accused must appear before the Lord by coming to the priest and judges in office at the time. But if a malicious witness comes forward and accuses someone of a crime, then both the accuser and the accused must appear before the Lord by coming before the priest and the judges in office at the time. The judges must investigate the case thoroughly. If the accuser has brought false charges against his fellow Israelite, you must impose on the accuser the sentence he intended for the other person. In this way, you will purge such evil from among you. Then the rest of the people will hear about it and be afraid to do such an evil thing. You must show pity. You must show no pity for the guilty. Your rule should be life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, foot for foot. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. You guys are noisy tonight. Come on, go lay down, hon. Go lay down. Go lay down. And we're turning to 1 Peter. Hon, go lay down, please. 1 Peter. Sorry, I had to have a side conversation with my dog. I taught him sign language. 1 Peter, chapter 2. So get rid of all evil behavior. Hey, we just heard that in Deuteronomy. So get rid of all evil behavior. Be done with all deceit, hypocrisy, jealousy, and all unkind speech. Like newborn babies, you must crave pure spiritual milk so that you will grow into a full experience of salvation. Cry out for this nourishment now that you have had a taste of the Lord's kindness. You are coming to Christ, who is the living cornerstone of God's temple. He was rejected by people, but he was chosen by God for great honor, and you are living stones that God is building into his spiritual temple. What's more, you are his holy priests. Through the meditation of Jesus Christ, sorry, through the mediation of Jesus Christ, you offer spiritual sacrifices that please God. As the scriptures say, I am placing a cornerstone in Jerusalem, chosen for great honor, and anyone who trusts in him will never be disgraced. Yes, you who trust in him recognize the honor God has given him. But for those who reject him, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and he is the stone that makes people stumble, the rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they do not obey God's words. They stumble because they do not obey God's word, and they meet the fate that was planned for them. But you are not like that, for you are a chosen people. You are.
This is a reminder.
Alexa, stop.
Medicine for Seeger. This is a reminder. Medicine for Seeger.
Thank you. But you are not like that, for you are a chosen people. You are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's very own possession. As a result, you can show others the goodness of God, for he called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. Once you had no identity as a people, now you're God's people. Once you received no mercy, now you have received God's mercy. Dear friends, I warn you as temporary residents and foreigners to keep away from worldly desires that wage war against your very souls. Be careful to live properly among your unbelieving neighbors. Then even if they accuse you of doing wrong, they will see your honorable behavior and they will give honor to you when he judges the world. For the Lord's sake, submit to all human authority, whether the king as head of state or the officials he has appointed. For the king has sent them to punish those who do wrong and to honor those who do right. It is God's will that your honorable lives should silence those ignorant people who make foolish accusations against you. For you are free, yet you are God's slave, so don't use your freedom as an excuse to do evil. Respect everyone and love the family of believers. Fear God and respect the king. You who are slaves must submit to your masters with all respect. Do what they tell you, not only if they are kind and reasonable, but even if they are cruel. For God is pleased when, conscious of his will, you patiently endure unjust treatment. Of course you get no credit for being patient if you are beaten for doing wrong. But if you suffer for doing good and endure it patiently, God is pleased with you. For God called you to do good even if it means suffering, just as Christ suffered for you. He is your example, and you must follow in his steps. He never sinned nor ever deceived anyone. He did not retaliate when he was insulted, nor threaten revenge when he suffered. He left his case in the hands of God, who always judges fairly. He personally carried our sins in his body on the cross so that we can be dead to sin and live for what is right. By his wounds you are healed. Once you were like sheep who wandered away, but now you have turned to your shepherd, the guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And day by day with St. Francis, which is a weird little thing because it's this little snippet of one sentence from the life of St. Francis, but whatever. Let's see what it says today for May 2nd. When you see a poor person, you may... Let me try that again. When you see a poor person, you are looking into a mirror of the Lord and his poor mother. When you see a poor person, you are looking into a mirror of the Lord and his poor mother, says Solano in Second Life. Christ himself urges us to see him in the poor in the parable of the sheep and the goats. All the great saints took this directive very seriously. One saint even used to ask the poor for their blessings. Lord, when did we see you hungry and give you something to eat, or thirsty and give you something to drink? That is a big deal. That's my whole... And it was a, I mean, the Order of Friars Minor, of the Franciscans Order of Friars Minor, the Friars Minor could basically be the order of the least of these, the friars of the least of these, which is what Jesus says. Anyone, whatever you do for the least of these, you do for me. And so they were of the least of these, so they themselves were the least of these by denying all wealth and possessions and taking on voluntary poverty and becoming beggars for the kingdom of God. But they were also the least of these because that was their concern. They were doing what they were doing for behalf of the poor, to identify with the poor, to be in solidarity with the poor. And so to follow Christ, who says to sell all that we have and give the money to the poor, and to be one with the poor. Anyway, I don't know where that was about, and I'm going to stop rambling, so let's get back to the prayer section of the prayers. Our Father, give us today our daily bread. God of seed and growth and harvest, creator of need, creator of satisfaction, give us, we pray, our daily bread, sufficient and assured for all. Give us also, we pray, the bread of life, and we shall have a care to feed the hungry, and to see and to seek for peace and justice in the world. Help us then to remember and to know that you are our life today and every day. You are the food we need now and forever. Look kindly, all-seeing God, on all who spend this night in anxiety or pain. Be with those who will die tonight. Look kindly on those who are without food or shelter, on those who have no love. Your will is that we should have a life and share it. Be present, merciful God, and protect us through the silent hours of this night, that we who are wearied by the changes and chances of this fleeting world may rest upon your eternal changelessness. Amen. And turning to my well-worn Book of Common Prayer. This is not a book that sat on the shelf, but has been a book that has been taken out into the battle. So let's see. Father, we pray for your holy church, that we all may be one. Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you, that your name may be glorified by all people. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, that there may be justice and peace on the earth. Give us grace to do your will in all we undertake, that our works may find favor in your sight. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, that they may be delivered from their distress. Give to the departed eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy. May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom. Let us pray for our own needs and for the needs of others. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people and the multitude of your mercies. Look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Christ Jesus was in the form of God, yet he did not think to grasp at equality with God, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, and was born in our human likeness. Being found in our human state, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name above every name, that at the name Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Living God, in you there is no darkness. Shed upon us through this night the light of your forgiveness, your healing, and your peace, that when we wake from sleep, we may know once more the brightness of your presence, through our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May we grow in grace and knowledge of our Lord. May we grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to whom be glory both now and to the day of eternity. Amen. Alleluia. Amen. Peace and all good, beloved. I hope you all have a good night.